everyone, it's Kim here at Hancock Homestead and Gardens, and it's time for another Vita video. And today it's Wednesday. So it was supposed to be walk around Wednesday, but we've had rain all morning and it's pretty wet outside. And to tell you the truth, there's really not a whole lot new to show this week, but I'm sure there's going to be a lot of new stuff coming up next week. So I'm going to save the walk around for next week. And this week I'm going to do the accent challenge. I'm going to do what you talking about. Okay, so this challenge was set out by Farmer Meemaw. And so far, many of my subscribers, channels that I subscribe to, is doing it. So I thought today I would just jump on the bandwagon and try it myself. Okay, now I'm from Missouri, the Midwest. So that's where my accent is coming from, the Midwest. Or my family, the way I was brought up. Because both sides of my parents were German descents, so might have a little German in me, but anyway. Aunt, as in Aunt Dolores. Roof, the top of our house is called a roof. Route, we're going to take that route to get to town. Sometimes it will be a route, depending on like Route 66, but most of the time it's going to be a route. Wash, I wash the dishes, I wash the clothes. Oil, John puts oil in the car. Theater, now, if we're just going to the movies, you know, like where you walk in line and you pay for a ticket and you buy popcorn and you go watch the latest movie, then we call it we're going to the movies. We don't call it theater unless it's fancy. You know, if we're going to the Fox Theater, then we might say we're going to the theater. But normally we're just going to the movies. Salmon. Caramel. Caramel, my favorite candy. Fire. Do not like the word fire because in 2005, our house burnt down. And so fire is a very scary word for us. And that morning, both of my girls were yelling, fire, fire, you know, and it was scary. Okay, water. Sure. Sure thing. Data. Ruin. Crayon. New Orleans. Pecan. Pecan pie. I love pecan pies. My daughter makes the best pecan pie. But she learned it from her grandma. Fake Grandma Rusty taught my daughter how to make the best pecan pie. Both. Again, Alabama, spitting image, a lot of things in our family, we drop the G's, you know, we're going to go running, we're going to go swimming, you know, we very seldom say running, swimming, you know, those G's just seem to fall off. Lawyer, coupon, we do not wear pajamas, we wear PJs, cot, naturally, alumina, and that's a hard word for me, I don't know why, but I've never been able to say that word, so I usually just say, can you hand me the tin foil? Okay, envelope. All right, and now for the sentences. An Africa-bound girl went really fast on these sentences, so I'm hoping I got them all right. What do you call throwing toilet paper at houses? Okay, I remember as a kid, we used to do this on Halloween night. We didn't usually throw them at the houses. We would throw them at the trees and bushes, and it was called TPing, okay? And I grew up in a very, very small town with less than 200 people, and yes, we did TP each other. Okay, what do you call the little bugs that curl up? Roly-polies. What do you call the carbonated fizzy drink? Soda. However, something that Africa-bound girls said is that down in the South, they call it Coke. And that is so true. When we went down for my son's wedding in Texas, they kept asking us, do you want a Coke? Do you want a Coke? And I thought to myself, is that the only beverage they drink? And then I realized that they were asking if we wanted a soda. So yeah. Okay. Athletic shoes are called sneakers. When I address groups of people, it depends on who the people are. When I was a school teacher and I had to stand in front of parents, you know, I might say, hello, parents. Hello, ladies and gentlemen. You know, when I was addressing the students, you know, I would say, hey, boys and girls, or hey, students, you know. When I address my family, I usually say, hey, y'all. Hey, y'all, it's time for supper. So, yeah, that's, you know, that's when my South comes in, my Midwest Southern accent is when I'm yelling for supper. Hey, y'all, supper's ready. Or what y'all doing today? So it just, you know, depends on the situation there. I know that when I started making my YouTube channel, I had the hardest time trying to figure out how to address you guys. Because if you watch my very first videos, you'll see where I say, hello, family and friends. And then after I got into it, I realized, well, not everyone out there is a family or a friend. Some of them are YouTubers. So then I would go, hello, family and friends and YouTubers. And then I thought, man, that's going to get awfully long, you know? And so I would watch other people and listen to the way they would say it. And I'd be like, no, that's not me. No, that's not me. So I really kind of wanted to just go, hey, y'all, it's Kim here today. And I thought, oh, my gosh, that just sounds so hick, okay? Yes, Farmer Meemaw, I'm calling you a hick. So I went to hello, everyone. And hello, everyone is kind of my in-between formal and informal. So hello, everyone. And hey to you, Farmer Meemaw. Okay, a spider with long legs is called a granddaddy long leg. Grandparents. Names. Well, it kind of depended on which grandparent I was addressing, because I had Grandma Wiesman, and there we used Grandma and then her last name. But I also had Granny Kate, and there we went with a little bit more informal beginning and a little bit, and then the first name, Granny Kate. I had Granny Plaster. So there we had the informal beginning and yet the formal last, and Papaw Plaster. So just, you know, each grandparent kind of had their own title. Now, in our family, Jeffrey is calling me Meemaw, and we have used G-Paw for John. And the reason he got G-Paw was at Christmas time, when I would put the little labels on his packages, I was writing to Jeffrey from Meemaw, and I was going to write Grandpa John. And I was like, man, that's just too long. Grandpa John is just too long. So I would write G, Paw, John. And I go, oh yeah, that works out pretty good. So we went from, we went to Meemaw and G, Paw. Okay, what do you call the cart for groceries? We just call it a cart. Most of the time when we walk into Walmart or any store, I'll say, can you grab a cart? What do you call it when the sun's shining and it rains? A sun shower. I don't know how many other people call it that, but I know Africa Bound Girl, she said it, and I was like, yes, yes, that's what I call it too, sun shower. What do you call the thing that you use to work the TV? A remote or a remote control, depends on how fast we want it. Okay, and then throwing in a few others here. We call our sofa a couch. We eat breakfast, lunch, and supper unless it's formal. If we're going out, or if it's a celebration or a holiday, then we call it dinner. We're going out to eat dinner. We're going to have Thanksgiving dinner. But if it's informal for just us every day, then it's supper. Sometimes we will have brunch. I don't know how many other people have brunch, but a lot of times on church days, I won't eat a breakfast, I'll eat a brunch. And that's where I have a breakfast type lunch near lunchtime, but it's breakfast food. Okay, so brunch. A couple other things I want to throw in there. This is to tease my daughter, Karen. We call the stuff that you put on potatoes gravy, okay? But one night we were all sitting around, and she was a teenager, you know, so she knew better. We were all sitting around the table, and she was trying to tell us to pass the gravy. And I guess her brain just had a brain block, so she asked for the potato sauce. So every once in a while, we have to tease Karen about wanting the potato sauce. Okay, yeah, that's how I talk in my house. It just depends on the situation, whether it's formal or informal or somewhere in between. And it depends on how fast we want something done and who we're addressing. So anyway, thank you for Farmer Meemaw for getting this started. It's been a lot of fun listening to other people's accents. And thank you, Africa Bound Girl, for coming out of your comfort zone to tag other people. And